this week's main event.
Boy, this one will be physical, as we said. Buzz Sawyer and Arn Anderson both have perfected their wrestling technique.
Listen, that Buzz Sawyer, he's giggling. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, he's from California, the land of fruits and nuts. You know, they got a great climate out there for growing things. Unfortunately, I don't think Buzz knew about that when he was trying to develop his brain power. He is gone, but he's a bad apple.
He certainly is. Collar and elbow tie up. And they're locking up like two bulls right there. Nick Patrick, the referee. This match here on TBS is for the television championship of the world. As Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer with a big chop on Arn Anderson. Both these men have extremely high threshold of pain. There's the elbow whip. But Arn Anderson caught coming in right in the face. Sawyer caught him coming in. Got the right foot up. Oh, he missed with the elbow.
It's starting out just like we knew it would, Jim. And I tell you what, this one's for the world television title. If you think this action is something, then wait till that Clash of Champions, the Texas Shootout, February the 6th. You're going to see Arn and Sting and Ric Flair in a cage against Buzz Sawyer, the Great Muta, and the Dragon Master live on TBS. It's going to be an awesome match.
Watch this. Oh, he went for the clothesline. He just wrapped that arm around the steel post. And the post did not even register. And he does it again. Arn Anderson now.
If it had been his head, the post would have registered.
Anderson working over Sawyer's arm. And Double A, the enforcer of the Four Horsemen, versus the leader of the Sawyer Muta Dragon Master trio.
Triumvirate. That's a good word. When you say Arn Anderson is the enforcer, are you saying if somebody owes the Four Horsemen money, he's the guy to collect it? Is that what you're implying?
You don't want him knocking on your door.
I wouldn't want him knocking on my door even if he wasn't mad at me. I'll probably eat you out of house and home.
That Anderson style, slamming the arm, that hammerlock position, slamming it down to the arm bar. It's Anderson with a wide base. Sawyer is at a disadvantage.
Wait a minute, what are you saying about Anderson's wide base? Is that a crack on his physical characteristics or
what?
What
is it? The positioning of his feet in the arm bar.
I tell you what, I've never seen Bill Sawyer as ready for anything as he's ready to take this belt tonight. He's wanting some revenge, but he's got to keep his eye on the ball.
Good arm drag by Arn Anderson, the television champion, who 7 days ago right here on the Power Hour defeated the Great Muta for the television championship.
And I said at that time, Jim, you'll remember, with Buzz Sawyer and the Dragon Master outside the ring facing the Great Muta, I said Arn Anderson had to be Superman, Batman, and Green Lantern rolled up into one to walk out of that ring with the belt. Well, he did it. That still doesn't mean he's Superman, Batman, and Green Lantern. That just meant that the other three guys had an off night.
Sawyer is biting Anderson right in the thigh. Anderson didn't even let go of the hold. He took the pain and kept right on dishing it out. And Anderson now being punished by Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
That Buzz Sawyer, he holds a grudge, doesn't he?
He does.
I tell you what, you know, I'm just wondering, why isn't a woman going after some guys like Sawyer and Muta and Dragon Master? Tough guys like that. I wonder why do you think she wants Arn Anderson out of the horseman? What do you think, Jim?
Nice arm drag. I think she's got her sights set on the Nature Boy, if you want to know the truth about it. And it's only my assumption. I'm just looking at all the facts that as I see them. And I tell you something, if Ric Flair's got one weakness, it might be women. Because he is the supreme
ladies. Yeah, he sure is, isn't he?
Don't try to follow him around, he'll kill you. Now, secondly, I don't think, though, that Flair will ever mix business with pleasure. I don't think that he will turn his back on Ole or Arn or Sting to have anything to do with woman. I believe that.
Woman's got a lot to offer.
I can think of several things he has to offer, none of which we'll probably need to go into. She's a very wealthy woman, but Flair's wealthy as well. I can't see her. I don't know. I hope.
Well, all we can say about woman is so far since she's been in professional wrestling, whatever she's wanted, she's got her. Right now, Arn Anderson's getting something that he don't want, and that's a beating from Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer.
Sawyer, the big right hand, right in the rabbit punching, right in the back, right in the neck. Straight right hand by Buzz Sawyer. Here comes Double A. Anderson is a southpaw. Watch that left hand if you can. Mad Dog comes from the right side.
And Anderson's been going after that arm on Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer for quite a bit now. He keeps going back to it, which is smart wrestling. Anderson's a smart wrestler. He executes everything he does just about as well as it can be executed. Textbook examples of wrestling. At the same time, he's tough. Like you said, he can absorb a lot of punishment. I think the disadvantage here is the fact that Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer is crazy. He'll do anything.
I couldn't agree more with that. And Sawyer catching Anderson coming off the ropes. He nailed him. Anderson turned around on the ropes. I don't think he thought Sawyer was that close to him, but Sawyer followed him in and kicked him right in the gut.
Anderson trying to regroup, trying to get some air back in his gut again right now. The Mad Dog goes over to the ropes, and he'll take it outside the ring in a heartbeat if he feels the time is right to do it. But instead, he's trying to bring Arn back in the ring. He's going to win the title. You can't win the title outside the ring. You got to bring your man in and beat him on the inside.
Big chops there by Mad Dog, reversed, however, by Arn Anderson. Anderson, 12 frog. This could be all. A power slam. One, two.
I don't believe it.
Anderson got the left shoulder up.
He just barely escaped with that television title. Because he tried that leapfrog and Buzz Sawyer took him over in that patented power slam. Now he's picking him up again. He's going to work on those ribs and on the back.
Sawyer on top, got two. Anderson got the shoulder up, the left shoulder is up. Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer now has the advantage. And the television champion of the world is in trouble as Sawyer goes for a bear hug.
How'd you like to be locked in a cage with Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer?
No,
or the Great Muta, or the Dragon Master. That's the fate that awaits Arn Anderson, Sting, and Nature Boy Ric Flair on the Clash of Champions, February the 6th.
What a suplex by Sawyer. Floats over on top, and Anderson again kicks out. That's three times that Sawyer has got inside two before Anderson kicked out. Back to the bear hug.
The more I see of these two guys going after it, the more I think of what that six-man tag is going to be like. You got a lot of great matches that night. You've got the Road Warriors taking on the new Skyscrapers. You've got Rick and Scott Steiner going up against Doom. It's going to be the World Tag Team title versus the Masks. We could see Doom unmasked right on live TV. A lot of other great matches, but I think the six-man in the cage is going to be the topper of a great evening.
That will be on Tuesday night, February 6th, live here on TBS Clash 10, the Texas Shootout. Anderson trying to go for a slam, but Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer has worked on the back for the past several moments.
I'll tell you what, Arn Anderson has had just a little bit of a string of bad luck.
Here's Sawyer again, one. He got two, and Arn Anderson kicks out. That's four times that Anderson has come within less than one of losing the title.
Anderson's luck's been so bad, he got a divorce. The judge gave him custody of his mother-in-law. He can't get anything going the past couple of minutes. You probably know a lot about that too, Jim.
No comment.
He can't get anything going here the past couple of minutes. Try as he might, Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer is keeping him pretty well under control. But Arn Anderson, I called him out last week. I'm not going to do it again because you never know with this guy.
Anderson is in deep trouble. That is a gross understatement. Sawyer has worked on the back and has worked on it relentlessly. Arn Anderson, I've said publicly many times, I've never met any athlete, underscore the word athlete, any more mentally tough than Arn Anderson. But how much can any human being take? The abdominal stretch and the lower back being punished as Sawyer holds the tights for additional leverage.
I think his hand just happens to be hung up. He probably doesn't even realize it's there. See, he let go while the referee was around.
He's very good-hearted, and so is Manuel Noriega now that he's behind bars. He's very humble.
Do you ever notice the difference, the resemblance, I should say, between Manuel Noriega and Arn Anderson's Uncle Gene?
No, but I'll look at it next time. Boy, I tell you, Corny, this abdominal stretch, it's a tough hold. And Anderson trying to free that leg. He does it. Hip-hocking Buzz Sawyer over. But Double A is down, and the Mad Dog right back to work on the lower back.
That's the only problem with a guy like Sawyer trying to apply the abdominal stretch. He's stocky. His arms and legs aren't really long enough to exert the proper leverage on a guy like Anderson to keep those legs grapevine.
Sawyer Tossing Arn Anderson outside. If you just joined us, Jim Ross and Jim Cornette.
They know who we are.
Sold out Saginaw Michigan Civic Center. This match for the television championship. Buzz Sawyer challenging Arn Anderson, who is currently on the floor outside the ring and in, obviously, a lot of trouble.
Now, you see, you accused last week, you accused Muta of having his friends come out and help him just because Buzz was there. Oh, shot to the midsection. Just because Buzz was there, just because Dragon Master was there at ringside last week, you accused Muta of getting help. Well, see, tonight, Buzz is doing it all on his own. He's not asking any friends to come out and help him. He's taking Arn Anderson on one-on-one. Oh, my God, he moved the ring.
Good God, he moved the whole ring, ramming his back into that thing. The ring swayed. Unbelievable. Sawyer just rammed Anderson's back into the... And the ring post, I'll be surprised if he gets back in the ring.
Did you check that audio? I think I heard Nick Patrick ask Arn Anderson if he wanted to give it up.
Come on, bring it up.
So far, he's not doing it.
He won't
I wouldn't
quit.
Blame him if he did.
Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer ramming Arn Anderson back into the corner. Sawyer may be on his way to winning the television championship. Back, but he made a mistake there.
And he ran right into that turnbuckle with the arm that Arn Anderson has been working on for a good part of the match.
Anderson now the left hand to the midsection. That's back hit twice.
Oh, yeah. How about those teeth he knocked out before? He dropped his head right down under the chin and knocked a few. There's a good thing for Dr. Crook.
Right there, the high elevation. The crowd here with that four horseman sign. And now Anderson throws Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer outside.
Wow! Right into that ring post. And now shoving Sawyer back in. Arn Anderson has finally got it uncorked. He's looking to make the most of it.
Got him in. There's a spine buster. Anderson, what a miraculous comeback he has made. Lateral press. Got one. Got two. And Sawyer kicked out, yes. We're a half a count away from the kick it out.
Wait a minute. That's the Dragon Master. The Dragon Master in the ring. And there's Muta, Jim.
Well, he's
fighting. They're leaving them. They've done their job.
We're going to be back right after this. We'll be right back.